I'd like to thank the organizer for giving me an opportunity to present this result. This is a rather ongoing work. And I'd like to warn you first. I'm going to talk about the reverse mathematics, but the reverse mathematics, I should put constructive here because I'm going to use inductive logic instead of classical logic doing reverse mathematics. And also, classical reverse mathematics is developed over second order arithmetic, that is arithmetical system. But in this talk, we use set theoretic system. Okay, that's a 2 point. And this is a joint work with PhD student of mine and Tatsuji. Unfortunately, he is in Oxford now, today, and also Takako. She's over there. Okay, I'd like to start with a short history of background of this talk. In 2006, Peter Axel introduced a notion of set-generated DCPOs in his paper on general topology developing within his set theory, C-Z-A. And Eric and I worked on constructing a quotient topology within CZA and type theory. I think this is, I should say that this is an extension of CZA. We have constructed quotient topology. And then I tried to investigate the construction in this paper, and then I started to investigate the construction carefully, and we proposed the so-called generalized geometric theory to characterize the construction. But in parallel, Benno van der Bell, Benno is there, introduced a principle NID. And so-called non-deterministic inductive definitions. And NID and GGT is very close. And unfortunately, I have to say that the NID is much simpler than GGT. So I'd like to talk about the non-deterministic NID today. And also, Tatsuji and I show the category of basic pairs. I would like to I'm going to give a definition of basic pairs and complete space, complete and complete, co-complete in the extension of this action, SGA. And also Takako and I introduced an NID principle called nullary NID and proved that nullary NID is equivalent to fullness in a subsystem of ECSD of CZA. Okay, so then I'd like to introduce this set, sorry, which is the base system for our reversion. So elementary constructive set theory, the language is usual set theory, binary predicate, equality, and membership. And the axioms and rules are inductionistic predicate logic with equality, and set theoretic actions are the following: extensionality as usual, pairing, union, and restricted separation, not a full separation. That means this formula is restricted to so-called delta node formula, which is all quantifiers are bounded in this way. Okay? And also, ECST has replacement as usual formulation, and also strong infinity. Okay, so we have a set of natural numbers in that sense. Okay. And this is quite weak set theory without power set action. We don't have power set action. But we can do many, many mathematics in this framework. For example, Cartesian product can be defined and function can be defined. And also we use a special notion called total relation or multivalued function, which is a subset of A times B for every X in A, there is a Y B in X and Y are related. Okay. This is total. Function is that is single valued total relation. So in the following, we use the notation MB and B to A to denote that MB, AB is the class of total relation between A and B. This is a class, okay? Not a set. And also, B to A means the class of function from A to B. And sometimes we would like to have that class of finitely enumerable subsets of a set as a set. So we need the following action, finite power action. That means class of function from natural number n to a is a set. And I'd like to quickly look into the CZF. Okay? It's an extension of ECSD, and which has so-called strong collection instead of replacement. And it has a subset collection, which is very complicated, but I'm going to give an equivalent formulation of subset collection later. And epsilon induction. This is the CZF. And in ECSD, subset collection implies fullness. That means for any set A and B, there is the subset of total, the class of total relation between A and B, and for any total relation can be approximated from below by an element in C. Okay? This is the fullness. And also fullness and strong collection implies subset collection. So in C that full set, fullness is equivalent to strong subset collection. Okay? And if we have fullness, then we can define B to A as a set, okay, using fullness. And also, I told you that ECST nor CZF does not have power set action, so for any set S, power S is a class, and we write in this way. This is an odd set, and defined by this form. Okay. So now I would like to introduce the notion of set generated classes, which Peter Axel introduced for ECDO. Given a set S, and let X be a subclass of power class of S, then X is set generated if there is a subset, this must be set G, called the generating set of X, such that for any element in X, and for any X in alpha, on alpha, there is a B in G, such that this whole. That means, for any alpha, alpha can be written in this way, beta. Beta is B. Beta. Same voltage. That means any alpha can be approximated from below by elements of G. Okay? Okay. And then it is easy to see that power class is a set generated in ECSD because we have the class of singletons as a set in ECSD. So take a set of singletons, then this is generating set for powers.
I'm sorry. Mm-hmm. How can you prove from the definition of set the generation that alpha actually coincides with that? The union, as I see it, is closed upwards, while is alpha supposed to be closed
so
upwards?
So that this guy
is
a subset of alpha. Do you agree?
Yeah.
So the other way around.
No,
because beta must be subset of alpha. So the union must be subset of alpha.
I'm sorry, that's the one I don't see. It's all right.
Is this okay? This union means union of these beta in Z. So this guy is okay, but by definition, we have the converse inclusion. Okay.
But you could have more unions of elements of G than X. Yes? X should be a subset of what is generated by G. I think this is the point.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
yeah,
yeah.
And I would like to define NID. So given a set S, a rule on S is a pair of subsets A and B of S. And a rule is called nullity if A is empty. And elementary if A is singleton. And finitely if A is finitely enumerable. Okay, we distinguish these things. And subset alpha of S is closed under a rule AD if A is a subset of alpha, then B intersects with alpha. This notation is B and alpha has a common element. Okay, and a set R of rules. R is a set of rules, and the subset R, alpha of S is R closed if it is closed under each rule in R. Okay? If rule is nullary or elementary, then it is finite. So, so NID principle said that for each set S and set R of rules on S, the class of R closed subset of S is set generated. Okay, this is NID principle. So then we restrict these rules to nullary, elementary or finitely, we have NID 0, NID 1, and NID less than omega. And NID less than omega implies NID zero and NID. Okay, this is trivial. So in 2015, Takako and I proved the following equivalent of ICST, Nullary NID and fullness. Mm-hmm. And also over ECST, NID1 implies NID0. Mm-hmm. So we can classify fullness by NID principle. And also this is a linear order. Okay? So now the next question is there something here and something there? Okay? So then I'm going to try try to find out is there any severance or something here or not. And we need some definitions to explain severance. Okay? So this is a basic pair which was proposed by Giovanni Sandi in Padua. Basic pair is a triple, X and S are set, and this V dash is a relation between X and S. And we like the special notation following Giovanni, diamond D means the image of D and this relation. And X U is the inverse image of U of pi under this relation. So relation pair between basic pairs are pairs of relation. X1 times X2 and S1 times S2, such that this equation holds. This means that this diagram commutes. So, and we have introduced an equivalence relation among the relation pairs. Two relation pairs are equivalent if this holds. Okay? That means these relations are same. Okay? That means that relation. Okay. Oh. So now we can define a category of basic pair. So we write the category by EE. So in the paper with Tatsuji, we show, if you look into the proof carefully, we have the following. We have two relation pairs, a parallel pair of relation pairs in DP. If this class is set generated, then the parallel pair has a coequalized. If you look into a proof of this paper, then you can find it. Actually, we show this one. And looking at this equation, we introduce the following NID principle. Subset alpha of S is biclosed under a loop AB if alpha intersect with A, then if and only if alpha intersect with B. So this is biclosedness, as usual, R biclosed means this, and NID by denote each set and each set of rules on S, the class of R by cross subset is set generated. And then we try to, the first we show that the NID by is equivalent to the existence of coequalizer. But later, we find that it is equivalent also element. The following are equivalent. NID1, NID by, and BP has coequalizer. And BP has small product in ECST, therefore BP is complete. Co-complete, co-product, therefore complete. Co-complete. And now we have found the theorem corresponding to NID1. So next year. So then we need another definitions. So this is the notation. For pre-order set and the subset D and E, we use the following notation. Down D is usual, and D down arrow E is intersection. And for singleton, we omit brackets. Okay? Mm-hmm. And given a basic pair, we can define pre-order. It's a standard pre-order on S by extent is a subset. So now, concrete space is a basic pair which satisfies these two conditions. This is very close to topological space. Suppose that X is a point of a topological space, and this V dash takes this V dash membership relation, and S to be an open set. Then, usual topological space satisfy these two points. And relation pair between basic pair is said to be convergent if this is abstraction from continuous mapping between topological spaces. Okay? And also, with this, this is object, and this is a morphism, then we have a category, the category of complete spaces and convergent relation pair. We denote C spot. Okay. And also, this is a formal topology, of course, due to Giovanni Sambin. It's a formal topology is a pre-order set equipped with a subclass. Subclass of this product satisfying these four conditions. And formal topology is set generated if there exists a family of subset, this one. So this triangle relation can be expressed by these sets. Okay, this is set. And also, formal point of a topology is the subset alpha, subset alpha of S. Alpha is inherited and satisfying this condition and that condition. And if the formal topology set presented, the condition 3 is equivalent this way. Okay. And also, maybe most of you are familiar with geometric theory. Given set S, geometric theory of S is a set T of form G of the form, this form. And the I is a set, sigma, tau, I are family, finitely enumerable subset. And the model of T is a subset alpha, such that. Then we have the following equivalence. Following the equivalent of DCST plus FPA, we need the set of finitely enumerable subset in this case. Finitely NID and concrete space, category of concrete space has an equalizer. And the class of formal points of set presented formal topology is set generated. The class of models of geometric theory is set generated. So now we have this picture that we have found.
Okay.
So then we try to introduce an array in I. That means the arity of A. So this rule is called NRD if there is a surjection from N to A, N onto A. Okay? Of course, the N plus one array, it is N plus two. This is trivial. Principle obtained by restricting R in NID to a set of NRE rules is denoted by NID N. But binary NID proves finitely. That means this part collapses. Okay. So unfortunately, we have finitely many principles. Only three principles. If we have many, then we can have a long list of equivalence, but unfortunately we will have three. Okay, this is the acknowledgement, and this is the reference. This is the paper Peter Axel introduced, set generated. The notion set generated. This is general geometric theory, and this is a set theory. Maybe you can look into this draft or report to see ECSD and things like that. And this is quotient processing. And this is with strategies about basic pair and C space, and this is the trueness things, and this, you can look into this paper for basic pairs and formal topology. And this is a paper by Beno. He introduced the non-deterministic inductive. Thank you very much.
Underlying logic, is it a
clinician?
Intuitionistic.
And what's the constant experience? I'm sorry, I don't know, but what's the proof that there is theoretic strength of all these CZF?
Cryptic
plotting.
What you do is less than that.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Plus, negative by dependent choice. CZF plus relativized dependent choice.
So you want to add dependent choice?
Yeah, relativized. It doesn't change.
It doesn't increase the strength.
Okay, maybe this guy is less than critical plastic. Because we can prove NID, finitely NID in CZF plus relativized dependent charge.
Sorry, just
what was the definition again of a
set being
closed
under a rule?
Which one?
Closed under a rule,
I
missed it.
What's
the definition?
The definition of what?
Closed
under a rule. Very closely related to what Peter Schuster working on, entailment relation. It's the same as a model of entailment.
Okay, other questions? This principle you call FBA, it really said, did I read it correctly that you said that for every natural number n, there should be the set of pairs. The set of n tuples of set of the set A should again be a set. Mm-hmm. You have this for each individual n, but not because you could also consider the set of all Kuratowski finite subsets of A to be a set. I mean, but that's not what you mean. Just for clarification.
Yeah, it's just.
Why is it?
FPA just borrowed from the Peter and Mihail's draft, and because we need the set of finitely enumerable set of
the function.
Yeah. Okay. Okay, and then by replacement and union, you get also the set of all Kuratowski finite subsets of A. Yeah, I see.
One last question, please.
And maybe one remark. So this axiom, FPA, I'm very pleased that you use it. So when one develops elementary constructive set theory, it seems to be a very natural axiom, and it's needed. And it's not only there. So for instance, there's this book by Devlin, where he developed constructibility, and he wanted to have a very basic set theory, classical, so that you can develop fine structure theory in it. And so it's called BS. And he made a mistake in this, and it was exactly that he didn't include this axiom. So it's, I think it's one of the axioms that are underestimated.
So is there any simple explanation why you can't get FPA by starting from, because you have Cartesian products, so obviously you can iterate those, and then it seems like you want to be able to apply replacements to, in order to get FPA. Is there any simple explanation why that doesn't work?
Please.
But you only have, maybe you only have an induction for delta zero formulas.
Yeah.
Okay. So let's thank those people again.